let's profit from the sun that enters my room. To show this a good quality audio amplifier with two transistors. I don't publish the schematic, it's in my books and on other videos on my YouTube channel. But anyway, let's look at it somewhat closer. Pan over the circuit. You can make it on a piece of varnished wood with a diameter from say 20 centimeters up to 10 centimeters and with a thickness from approximately 2 centimeters. And on the back side from that wood you can connect glue tin plate made especially from cola cans or etc. So underside tin plate. That has all to do with the shielding and the hum properties. The electrostatic microphone is connected here, and here you see the shielding. The shielding is connected only on one location to the minus from the preamp. That's very important because otherwise you get hum. So here there is shielding and one wire from that microphone capsule goes to the positive lead via resistor to supply the electronics inside the electric capsule, and the minus goes here via this wire to the minus and also the shielding. So here is the signal from that electric electrode capsule. It has to be supplied with a certain voltage, and here that is via the 2K2 resistor. There's not much more to tell. A two transistor amplifier with this potentiometer. You can set the amplification, and here all goes to the another power audio amplifier via a plug or whatever. Use a shielded cable if necessary. And the battery here is a 9-volt battery. It's bridged by a 1000 microfarad cap and a resistor and a cap. That all has to do with the properties from that amplifier. It must be supplied by a complete hum-free power supply, and the battery is complete hum-free. And this cap has the aim that on the longer term, when the battery gets old, the whole thing does not start to oscillate. Without this cap, this amplifier easily starts to oscillate. Anyway, this is more or less all to tell about this amplifier. Very simple, though on the other hand you have to take in account many phenomenon.